Hi guys, I'm Dr. Sunil Sharma. Today's topic is about Raman Wilson syndrome. Plummer-Vinson syndrome, or you can say Patterson Kelly Brown syndrome, or you can say sideropanic dysphagia, or you can say post-Crickard wave syndrome. Okay, so this is Plummer-Vinson syndrome, Patterson-Kelly-Brown syndrome, or sideropanic dysphagia, or you can say post-Crickard syndrome. Before describing this, I want to tell you some history about it. In 1912, Plummer described it as cardiospasm. He described there is cardiospasm in upper esophagus without anatomical narrowing. After that, in 1915, his pupils discovered some narrowing. But in 1947, this disease described Patterson and Kelly. They discovered it is triad. This is triad of iron deficiency anemia, post-Crickard wave, and dysphagia. So, Plummer-Vinson syndrome, PV syndrome, or Patterson Kelly syndrome, Brown syndrome. It is triad of iron deficiency anemia, post-Crickard wave, and dysphagia. Okay? So, this iron deficiency anemia, post-Crickard wave, and dysphagia called Plummer-Vinson syndrome. Why this happen in iron deficiency? It's more common in female than male. Ratio is about 86% to 14%. Female male ratio. Most commonly found in middle age woman after 30 year of age. It's common in 30 to 45 year of age which have been malnourished. Malnourishment leading to this iron deficiency. What happened? In iron deficiency anemia, iron deficiency. What it define iron deficiency? If it is hemoglobin less than 13 in male or hemoglobin less than 12 in female, leading to iron deficiency. This iron deficiency leads hyposensitivity, hypomotility, and degeneration in the hypopharynx, which lead to degenerative pharyngitis. Maybe sometimes sore throat, which lead to wave formation. So this is iron deficiency lead to hyposensitivity, hypomobility, degeneration in the hypopharynx, which ultimately lead to degenerative pharyngitis, wave formation. Wave may be formed anterior wave just behind the postcricoid, or it may be circumferential. So wave may be formed in anterior wave or circumferential. Second component is postcricoid wave. Postcricoid wave of this syndrome is maybe anterior type or circumferential type. Like this, this is the larynx, anteriorly larynx. So this wave may be formed like this, anterior type, or this wave may be in circumferential type. Then this wave can be diagnosed in like by barium swallow or by endoscopy. If patient come to you with dysphagia, you can do barium swallow or endoscopy in middle-aged woman. If you find this postcricoid wave either anterior type or circumferential type. Now third characteristic is dysphagia. Dysphagia that may be initially for solid, then leading to semi-solid, then ultimately for liquid also. That is progressive in time. Progressive dysphagia. There is always progressive dysphagia. Firstly solid, followed by semi-solid and liquid also. Atkinson et al. Graded it from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 type. If it is no dysphagia, means normal. No dysphagia, normal. Unable to swallow some solids, then it's grade 1. Then grade 2 is able to swallow certain semi-solids. Atkinson divided. Then able to swallow certain liquids and unable to swallow liquids. So Atkinson divided this dysphagia in Plummer-Vinson syndrome, grade 0, normal swollen without any dysphagia. Grade 1 is unable to swallow some certain solids. Grade 2 is able to swallow certain semi-solids. Grade 3 able to swallow certain liquids and unable to swallow liquids. This is grading of dysphagia. Now, how to diagnose Plummer-Vinson syndrome? Diagnosis is clinical plus lab plus endoscopy or barium swallow. If clinically you see a middle-aged woman with iron deficiency, you can say ferritin level, serum ferritin level less than 30 or MCV value less than 80 also, or hemoglobin less than 12 in female or less than 13 in male. So this defines iron deficiency. Now endoscopy or barium swallow, you can find where? Post-Crickward web in upper esophagus, post-Crickward web formation in upper esophagus. So this is diagnosis. DD may be like cardiospasm, GRD or post-Crickward carcinoma. Now treatment. Treatment of Plummer-Vinson syndrome is treatment. First is dilatation with CRE balloon. CRE balloon. These are very good balloons which is called controlled serial expansion balloon. This is the therapy of choice. CRE balloon, controlled serial expansion balloon. If you see esophagus, we put a guide wire with balloon catheter inside this. Here is the wire. Then we inflate it. So this balloon on guide wire inflated. So this, according to size of the lumen, we are doing the serial balloon dilatation. You can divide also this luminal Plummer-Vinson syndrome into mild, moderate and severe type. Suppose if lumen is narrowing, less than 1/2 of the lumen is narrow, then it is called mild Plummer-Vinson syndrome. If lumen is between 2/3 lumen is narrowing, that is called moderate type of esophageal web or post-Crickward web. If lumen is more than 2/3 is narrowing, then it called severe PV syndrome, or you can say severe web formation. So on doing this dilatation with CRE balloon, and most of the patient live with single dilatation about 80%, or some may require repeated balloon dilatation in this Plummer-Vinson syndrome. Secondly, what initially we are doing is dilatation with esophageal boogies, or you can say boogie dilatation. We have rigid boogie and we are putting this boogie is multiple size. It's come in frames from 20 to 40 frame size. We are mostly doing with 32 frame size boogie dilatation, that is more than sufficient, about 1.5 centimeter. Okay. Luminal expansion. So best method is dilatation with CRE balloon or dilatation with esophageal boogie with rigid esophagoscopy, or you have to give ओरल थेरेपी और पेरेंटल थेरेपी आयरन डेफिशिएंसी. यू हैव टू करेक्ट आयरन डेफिशिएंसी इन फोलिक एसिड. यू हैव टू गिव फेरस सल्फेट प्लस फोलिक एसिड. सो दिस इज अबाउट फोर थ्री मंथ यू हैव टू गिव थेरेपी. दिस इज अबाउट पेटरसन कैलिब्रॉन सिंड्रोम और पीवी सिंड्रोम. थैंक यू सो मच.